know, on the topic of anger and sadness and all that, I guess this is also very true to mostly the theme of Kingdom Hearts in general. Is that when your darkness overflows you too much, you just spiral out of control. I guess that's a lesson for me when I played the first game as well, because I knew I mostly hated the game, but I feel like my emotions, well then again, I replayed it through again, I still hate it honestly, but even back then, like, my hatred for Kingdom Hearts 1 was not justified. It's only when I replayed, I don't want to piss anyone else off, but it's only when I replayed it and had like a logical mindset and had more of a open-mindedness that I realized why I disliked the first game in the first place. Not because of, oh, this thing sucks or whatever, it's like, oh no. It's mostly because that I really let my emotions dictate my actions and my words. And, well, sometimes when it's in the benefit, it's good. When it comes to the negative side, where, like, hatred and dislikes and, like, just letting your hatred overflow you, that's when it becomes really bad, and it's really bad for your emotion to, like, dictate your opinions. So, yeah, I'm not sure if there's a chance for me to, like, improve on that, but I really want to eventually find a way to, like, just improve upon myself. So that I could be better later in the future. I know I'm like always like this, to say, oh, constructive criticism is always the key, and once you listen to them and what they have to offer, that's when you feel you're mostly justified. When you're mostly justified for your actions, when you're as objective as possible. At least that's how I put it to perspectives. That's why sometimes, like, whenever, like, someone's, like, really passive-aggressive and angry, I really don't take them all that seriously when they're like, oh my god, are you really doing this shit? No, no. Whenever that happens, honestly, I kind of, like, glance at it and, like, not really think of them too seriously because... Oh, shit. Because I feel... They really are letting their emotions dictate their actions. They're not thinking about this, like, on the other side of the spectrum. That's how I always like to go through things. Like, try to think of, like, both sides of the argument.
Don't take what Ventus owes.
Like, instead of going completely on one side, find different, like, the best way to, like, the best argument for your argument is to find the opposite of that argument and a benefit to that argument instead. Usually I don't like debates, which is why I hate going like one-sided, because like I always like being objective when it comes to both sides. I really can't defend for oneself at all, or attack oneself at all, because that's just not me. I always like to take things into both perspective, into both perspectives and think about it from there. Otherwise, I'm just gonna be like, people are gonna like misjudge me, thinking, oh, I'm just gonna be like that one side. The only time that I ever really say this thing is absolutely horrible is when there's absolutely no benefits or disagreement. Like, if a game is perfect, it's mostly because I can't find a huge amount of flaws with it, which is why I say a game is perfect. Or when a game is completely trash, it's because I can't find a whole lot of valuable positives for me to say that's a worthwhile positive. So yeah, that's how I go with things at least. Unless it misses, of course, that's fine too. Potion, whatever. Right, that sometimes does not work for some reason.
Heal.
Alright, this is good.
Feel the darkness.
I should probably save my D-Link for later as well. That's probably good.
Have I truly won?
Yeah, D-Links are very are pretty much a necessity, so saving that for the next battle is probably good. Alright. Here we go, this time, fight against Ansem, aka Xehanort. Or fake Ansem. At least from what I remember in the storyline of Kingdom Hearts. Okay, so this is the actual battle. Here we go. Defeat Xehanort and take back your body. Because my body is certainly ready. That's one way to avoid as well. Come on. Perfect, okay. So yeah, my counters... I think I do eventually have to attack him somehow, I just don't know, like, a good opportunity to do so. Like, I can't really find a whole lot of... a really good opening at all. Let's try now. No, that doesn't work. Fuck, really? Yeah, okay, that's not good. Be on the safe side. Oh, that reach. Oh, that deflects him too. That's probably good. Hold on. When I counted that time, that's a little bit tricky too. Okay. Yeah, dodging doesn't seem to be like a whole that viable of an option to getting rid of something. Otherwise, just gonna get like pelted constantly, I feel. Seems like countering is the best way, but it's also kind of a slow way as well, if you really think about it. It does damage him, actually. That's interesting. Actually, now that I think about it. I can't tell if that damaged him or not. Might have, but... it's a little bit too hard to figure it out. Missed. That's fine. Ooh. counter. I was being really, like, spammy when it comes to the counter button. I should not do that. That's something I really need to work on. Is, like, instead of, like, spamming the counter button, press the button at the right time. It's more of a reflexive thing, I feel. What? Oh, damn. Like that. But that time, I actually pressed it in time. Oh, I'm gonna die now, because... Yeah, this combo is essentially a 1-hit KO. I also have... Crap, I gotta remember that I have the, Sonic... Shadow Sonic, whatever it's called, that attack as well, so I could use that to my advantage. Walking is not a good option at all. Walking is not a good option at all. I can't stress that enough. Alright. So, no walking. Oh, wow, that was really lucky. I was more like anticipating it or anything. Oh, wow. What? Last attack too. Lucky me. It seems like as soon as you're strung into that combo, you're dead. It's really unpredictable too, but it's kind of like a really huge risk factor. Do I counter? Like, okay, you could try that, but you might be, like, using your counter frames too early. In turn, because of that, he can punish you afterwards. Okay, that attack is bullshit, I have to admit. A shadow attack with another shadow attack, especially with no way of, like, getting out of that. Because, like, as soon as you're done countering, you have, like, some frames of vulnerability. I really hate cheap attacks like that.
You have lost.
Yeah, I can't tell if that fireball attacked or not. See, I could have been really... I could have been punished after that. I'm think I'm dead. Yeah, I'm dead. Yeah, I can't find a really good opportunity to, like, constantly string him with attacks. It's really hard. I'm nowhere near fighting, like, killing him either.
Enough!
Oh. I think as soon as I get near him, he starts attacking somehow. I just don't know what attack he's gonna do. I just kinda have to anticipate him sometimes as well. Whoa, that's a new attack. Okay, that is a new attack. It might be because I dwindled his health down to a certain threshold, thus him getting a new attack because of that. Alright, so I'm definitely improving in that aspect, but adapting? That's a different story. Alright, come on. That's fine. That works, I guess. When he does that dash attack, I can't really... That's a close one. I didn't press X in time. Okay, so when I'm near him, that's where I'm still vulnerable to the Shadow Ball. When I'm in a distant range, I'm fine. I'm safe. But near him, that's a different question. So that's why I had to like press X immediately. Not that, but if I do press X immediately, I think the Shadow Balls actually do get hit as well. Oh, maybe not. Although, that could happen, which could be bullshit. I wasted my cure, that's fine. Damn. Countering is risky at the same time, though, because, like, again, he could take advantage of those vulnerability frames, and you're basically done. Oh, that was way too late than I anticipated. What? Enough! Yield! Enough! Remember, no running, just dash. You'll be fine. Yield! What? That's new! You have lost. That was really risky. More damage, actually, if I know the exact timing. Do that. Ah, shit. Which, of course, I don't. No, that's gonna be death, isn't it? Wait, I can't use my D-Links! Oh, shit, that's bad. Okay. I thought I could save that for this battle, but apparently I can't use my D-Links, so... It looks like it was blacked out, so... Is that any reason? You have an indication? I might be able to use some sort of power, some sort of attack fan feature if I use a certain type. Let me pay attention to his life bar. It didn't work, okay. That's a very risky attack. It's weird because, like, that works for Xehanort Phase 1, but for Vayne Phase 2, looks like I need to be in a different, like, moveset, but I can't do that, otherwise I'll have to restart again.
Enough!
Fuck. Okay. Let's see how this does. Yeah, a lot of focus on that. That's good. I wanted to be in a different position, but... Brawler.
Yield. Enough! You have lost! Yield! Enough!
Yeah, that's definitely a different attack. Dodging that will be kind of a nightmare, though.
Huh. Enough!
Fuck, okay. Yeah, that is a one-hit KO in that last attack. I need to increase my HP, but I don't know how. Aside from, like, maybe leveling up, of course, but... Alright, come on, let's do this again. Really? Really now, dude? Come the fuck on! God, he's reading me now. He's like, I know I'm anticipating a guard, so he's like, oh, I'll just let you guard, and then... He attacks. I thought I needed to be, like, a certain distance for him to attack, but... I don't know, I guess I wasn't enough?
Enough!
Wrong button. I pressed circle for some stupid reason. After that, though, I am very vulnerable. After that, so sometimes it's not even a safe option to do that. This might... I might have probably met my match here, but... Like, it wasn't like the, my Master's boss battle where I was like, oh, I feel like I could have an inch of it. Oh, shit! Okay, that's bad. But here, I was like, I can't find an opening at all. At least, not visible to the naked eye. I don't want to attack randomly. That's a good time to do it, right? Hopefully I'm lucky. Wow, I got really lucky there. After that homing attack, I don't know how to get rid of that. Because if I can't counter it, then my best bet is dodging it, but it's a homing attack, so...
Yield. Yield.
Wow, that's also a 1-2 KO attack. I might have said that in the first place, but like... I forgot, so... This might be impossible for me, honestly. Didn't mean to attack! Oh. Okay, he heals. That's the number one way I feel like we're going to be in a stalemate, because he's going to continue to heal and heal and heal. He's just going to be back to his original self. So I'm going to save it for there and figure out a plan to... Maybe I'll just grind on my own time and just... Yeah, because I really can't beat this dude at all. Ugh. Okay, sorry if this has been a huge waste of time, but I really can't beat this guy at this current state. What level am I right now? 26. Okay, so maybe I need to be a little bit more higher. I'll set my goals to like 35, maybe. And I'll call it like that. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the future of my Let's Plays. This is Bassinger signing out. So, I might have gone a lot overboard with the grinding, but, yeah, also I should probably edit my deck real quickly before I continue to start. Yeah, as you can tell, I feel like most of my issues could be easily relegated because of my low HP, because most of the attacks I've seen from the boss battles were pretty much one-hit KOs, so I feel like a boost in my HP should nullify that issue. So, that's where I was mainly going for when I was trying to grind up and forge my stuff, is for the HP boost. So, there's that. What do I specifically need? I don't think I need a whole lot of offensive capabilities. Slime Dash and Dark Haste seems to be like, go through thrust attacks, so... Aeroga, I don't know if magic's gonna like, work against him at all, so I'm probably not gonna bother with that. Just in case, I mean, that's a homing attack, so might as well, right? Oh, of course, Cura. Unless I have a higher Cura? No, I only have two Cura guys. I think that's fine, because, like, healing wasn't really an issue for me at all. So there's that. I still need to level up some of these, but, like, whatever. I'm at the final boss, so I don't think it's very necessary and mandatory. I don't think any of these really... Now that I think about it, it doesn't really... Try whirlwind spin attacks and send surrounding enemies flying. I mean, I'll try that though. I mean, if he's vulnerable in the air, then I guess that's one way though. In fact, actually, maybe we should put arrow inside. Only got two of them. One of them's not fully developed, but whatever, that's fine. Yeah, I think that should cover it. At least I hope so. So yeah, let me just save this real quickly. Get into the boss battle. Also, I'm recording this without any stopwatch because my phone's broken. So, determining the time should be a lot harder than anticipated. But, yeah. It should be fun. If I feel like it might be a long episode, then, I guess I'll tell you. Because I'm playing a recording Danganronpa after finishing Birth by Sleep. And because of that, I feel like I might be finishing basically two games at once, so... Yeah. I guess I could use my laptop for a stopwatch as well, just in case. So, there's that. Here, let me try and find a stopwatch real quickly. Meanwhile, we'll skip the cutscenes. Up until the boss battles. Oh, Google has its own stopwatch thing. Oh, perfect. Okay. So let's just add, like, maybe, like, 2 or 3 minutes into the timer. I swear, if I'm somehow not prepared by now to deal with the boss battle, then I don't know what the fuck to do, aside from just continue to grind, because that seems to be my only solution to beating him. Maybe that, or just keep getting better. I know his tactics, and I know his counters, so this shouldn't be too much of a hassle. Plus, I got a huge advantage now that I have more HP and shit. Probably more defensive capabilities and more, strength as well, so it shouldn't be too hard. Alright. Not only that, but dealing with these guys are probably gonna be way too easy as well. Alright, let's do this. See how I handle this.
Too slow.
Fuck, okay, right. Too slow. Oh yeah, I also have Surprise too, which should help me with even more invincibility frames. The only problem is it doesn't, like, dash attack onto the enemy. Instead, it, it kind of just, like, spins around, so I have to be, like, in a certain place to do so. Alright, I should heal.
Heal!
Perfect. Alright. That was easy. I didn't hear the bleep 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 kind of sound effect when I'm very low on health, so I think I should be really good by now. Alright, now I just have to deal with Xehanort and his old man form. Let's do this. Defeat Xehanort? Here we do this. Here we go. Here we do this? That sounds weird. Okay. Oh. Alright, Woodcutter is also... Okay, okay. This guy's also vulnerable in the air. Well, he's the same dude, so... Perfect. Invincibility frames, thank you. Oh crap, okay. Alright, what is this? Critical impact, perfect. I don't know, I think this... I didn't really use a whole lot of fire during that round, but okay. I'll take it. Oh, well that kind of nullifies the heal. Oh crap, oh! Alright. Perfect, thank god it heals like everything. Fuck, wrong button. That's fine. Just okay, good. Be an idiot. Alright. I also remember I have a block as well. So I should learn to do that more. Okay. And my HP is even increased even further, so why not have even more HP afterwards? Alright, I think I'm very well equipped into beating the boss battle by now. If not, wow, this game demands a lot of grinding if that's the case. Because I remember, I went to every single fucking world. I did 100% the treasures. I think that was like my main goal, but like I was like, oh, screw it. I don't know how to 100% every single treasure room. So I'm just going to go there for the grinding. But yeah. Okay. Okay, here we go. Fighting Xehanort and taking back my body. Let's do this. Right, this guy. Okay, so his tactic, I can only counter practically. Okay, yeah, this guy is pretty much completely invincible when I try to even attempt to attack him, so countering is the best strategy against this dude. I able to survive his one-hit KOs this time because of my HP. Okay, so it doesn't heal completely. Oh crap. I hate when he oh, that's not a heal attack, that's his... Okay. This I'm still reluctant on how to... Wait, I know how. Oh, fuck you for teleporting! Oh, well, at least I somehow did it. Yeah, I can't attack him at all, there's no way. Oh, this is new! What was that? Holy shit, okay. Whatever. You have lost. That's a big meteor! Better stop teleporting. Alright, here we go. This should do a lot of damage, hopefully. I keep forgetting this is the fastest way to kill him as well. I mean, we're almost limiting my tactics to a lot, aren't I? Oh crap! Okay. Please live this. Please live this. Please live this. We're living. We living. Okay. Fuck you. Fuck it. It's a little bit of focus. I don't think it's gonna damage him at all, but whatever. Oh, okay, that works. No. Sink into darkness. That's a new attack, I think. Ah, fuck. Oh. No, no, no. He's not healing right now, so I think he has a limit to how much he heals. I think I got this, I got this. I totally got this. Come on, really? You're not near me? Ow! Come on, heal up! There we go. How much? There we go. So yeah, a lot easier once you find out that grinding exists. I really didn't want to do that because I kind of like... One, I wanted the challenge, and two, I feel like I just don't want to like deal with more grinding stuff, as I'm like the type of person who just wants to get things over with, but yeah, finally did. It's kind of like an anti-climax, but like at the same time, if I was able to like beat him without the necessary for grinding, that would've been really cool and fun. Alright, so I beat him. Not sure what happens afterwards. Ah, my friends. I see them in the light. So basically in every... Is it that in every single character's playthrough, they practically die? Or something? Because, like, Inventus is ending. He's missing, but he's probably, like, presumed dead. Here, this is Terra's story. And here we are with Terra probably gonna be dead, too. So I'm guessing in Aqua's story, once we play through her and finish through it, she's gonna be dead, too. How does it make sense exactly? Is this like him giving his final energy to the... Stupid ant, what are you doing here? His final energy to the Kingdom of Hearts? Recovering Kingdom Hearts, sure, that... Like I said, Kingdom Hearts story is usually really, really... convoluted. I just don't pay attention to it too much. I do like the characters in this one, though. It's just, you know, as like story-wise, Aqua. Like, eh, whatever.
Then, one day, I will set this right.
And that's the end of Terra Story. So we got one story left to go. Can I skip this? Yes, I can. Okay. I got one story left to go, and I'm probably going to do that in the next recording session. I mean, not at the next recording session. Oh, hey. So, game mode, proud. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm going to get every single achievement for saving. Okay, save menu. Report completion 44%, so I didn't complete everything, but hey, whatever. Most used command, Sonic Shadow. Most used command, Style, Critical Impact. Most used D-Link, Cinderella. Really? Huh, I didn't know that. Enemy Sophia, that, okay. So let's save. And we'll finish it off with Aqua Story in the next recording session. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you in the future in my Let's Plays. This is Basinger, signing out.